privacy is under threat today. We all know that. I've been arguing to protect privacy as a commentator and an analyst for years. But when I learned that my own information had been taken by the IRS, this was a chance to get involved directly. I'm Jim Harper. I'm a technology policy analyst and a cryptocurrency investor. I got involved with cryptocurrency in 2011, made my first purchases and earned Bitcoin in 2013. I've been an investor and holder of some amount of Bitcoin ever since then. Cryptocurrency is entirely online. It takes the idea of dollar bills and coins and makes it into something that's entirely on the internet. It has no place, it has no jurisdiction. It's around the world on the net. I was aware before I received my letter that the IRS was pursuing information about cryptocurrency holders, but I didn't know I was one of them.
The Internal Revenue Service apparently has been engaged in a secret program of gathering private financial data from people in the United States who have used cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. Our client, James Harper, received a letter from the IRS last year saying that the IRS had gathered information about him and his activities and his use of cryptocurrencies and has decided that he probably didn't pay his taxes. They sent this threatening letter to tell him that he was under investigation.
I've done nothing wrong. In fact, I've done everything right. It's pretty hard to track your taxable gains in cryptocurrency, and I've done it in detail and reported every year and paid my taxes in full.
It is not okay for the IRS to seize people's private financial information without seeking a judicial warrant upon a showing of probable cause. There is no IRS exception to the US Constitution. Here, what the IRS did was they did not follow the Fourth Amendment requirements of legally obtaining Mr. Harper's private financial information. They did not obtain a warrant, they did not obtain a subpoena, they did not obtain a court order, they did not give Mr. Harper an opportunity to respond, they did not even notify Mr. Harper that they were seeking this information, and that is wrong.
The danger here is that the IRS is looking at all of your private financial information, your name, your address, your bank account number, and all the transactions that you've engaged in. And they're looking at it just to see what you're up to, just in case they think that a crime has occurred. That's not what we expect out of law enforcement, and that is a gross invasion of our privacy.
I'm hopeful that this case will show not only that the IRS was wrongful in gathering information about cryptocurrency users for no reason, but also that it may establish good law that shows that agencies just can't dip into any warehouse of information when they feel like it. They have to follow the rules, just like you and I do.